Hello, Capricorn. Welcome to your weekly forecast. This is your reading for the week ahead, December 6th through the 12th, 2021, for all Capricorns out there that may be watching. Capricorn suns, moons, risings, Capricorns on the house cusp. Those with their sun in the 10th house and Venus in Capricorn, you can watch this reading. Just a disclaimer, please keep in mind these are general forecasts. Of course, they may not resonate with everyone out there. As I always say, for the most accurate reading with the most accurate outcome, please come get a personal private tarot reading from either me or your favorite tarot reader out there. The easiest way to do that is to click down below in the description. You can find my website and scheduling page, or up in the right-hand corner there, I'll put a link. If you want to book a reading with me, that will take you directly to my scheduling page. Last announcement, my 2022 New Year forecast, the complete forecast for the year ahead are available. These are private readings, obviously, where I forecast, you know, each month of the new year, plus an overall theme or challenge for the year ahead. And we're going to, then I explore each of those in depth and give you advice and guidance going forward. If you'd like to book that, I've put a link down below in the description for your convenience as well. So Capricorn, for your reading today, we are using the Modern Witch Tarot Deck by Lisa Stirl or Sturley. Also the Moonology Oracle cards here, just to see, just to give you some extra guidance at the end of the reading. These are by Yasmin Boland and these are by Lisa Stirl. I've listed those below for your convenience. Let's go ahead and jump into this reading. We are looking at 6 cards for your week ahead, Capricorn. I have timestamped the actual reading time in the description as well. Spirit, what can Capricorn expect? What's coming down the pipeline for Capricorn? What are the most important messages and energies you want to share with Capricorn? December 6th to the 12th, 2021, all Capricorns out there that may be watching, Capricorn suns, moons, risings, Capricorns on the house cusp, those with their sun in the 10th house and Venus in Capricorn. So the word that's coming to mind here is the word cumbersome. Okay, something is cumbersome, something is archaic, something is old, something is stuck in the past, something's in the dark ages, something here needs to be brought up to modern standards, or something is just too slow for most people. Bottom of the deck, we have the Tower in reverse. Scorpio, Pluto. Pluto is direct in your sign. Check the degree. Something's going on here. Underlying theme or challenge of your weekly forecast, there's going to be some kind of shake-up, emergency. This is the check engine light coming on in your car, letting you know proverbially, right, proverbial check engine light here, metaphor, of course, for something needs to change. Something needs to be shaken up here. The universe is asking you to shake things up in your life. Okay. Others of you could be dealing with a Scorpio who's going through something here. I'm getting an emergency, but you catch it before it gets bad. Okay. The cracks are starting to show, but you catch it before it completely crumbles here. All right, so let's see. Capricorn, how do you see yourself today? King of Cups. What's this saying here? I want to say smooth waters run deep. Okay, you might be feeling a lot right now, but you're not showing it, okay? You're kind of cool, calm, and collected. Kind of get a little of a poker face here. Are you playing poker? I don't know. You're definitely thinking about something here. You're not reacting. You're kind of taking something in. This is water energy, Scorpio, Cancer, Pisces. Something might surprise you, but I feel like you're just kind of like chilling with it. You're just understanding it. You're just sitting with it. So that's nice. Let's see. Your theme for the week is the King of Wands. Looks like you might be having a conversation with a fire sign. It could be a Leo. I'm seeing two strong masculine energies here, strong leadership. Also, the theme for you over the next week is taking the wheel here, leadership, entrepreneurialism, loyalty, leadership, management, you know, good sportsmanship. I don't know. There's something here about, I see a conversation going on here is what I see. Okay. I see water sign and fire sign here. In your past, you did learn a lesson regarding the hanged one or the hanged man, Pisces. In the past, you had an opportunity to see something from another perspective. Change the way you look at things, and the things you look at change. Dr. Wayne Dyer, okay? So with that philosophy here, you were able to observe some situation in your life as an impartial stranger. You were able to kind of step outside of yourself and look at things from a different perspective. That allowed you to do a couple of things, I feel. One, be empathetic. Two, be compassionate. Three, maybe even stand in someone else's shoes. Walk a mile in a man's shoes. Walk a mile in another man's shoes. You really get to see what his experience is like. Okay, so this was a good experience for you. It might have felt like pressing the pause button. This might have been you at a crossroads here. You use this time wisely, I feel. Your challenge this week is the Nine of Swords. Anxiety. Someone here is worried about something. Someone here has a lot of maybe up at night here, you know, restless leg syndrome, anxiety, insomnia. Something keeping you up at night here. This is like repetitive thought patterns. You might be having some bad dreams. This is also you doing some sort of shadow work here. It looks like the nights are going to be hard for you. You're having a hard time sleeping. You may want to go to get that checked out. I'm not saying for sure, but if it's something that's really chronic, don't let it fester. The lesson you're learning now is the Seven of Cups. Scorpio, this card talks about fantasies, brainstorming, creative options, also delusions. You know, the clouds here are not clear. We're not thinking clearly. We're kind of up in the clouds here. So you're learning a lesson regarding the Seven of Cups this week. You might be exploring options here. You might be getting into more creative types of mind frames, fantasy realms, escapism. What's really in these cups? You know, one has a rose, one has a heart, one has a snake, one has a tornado, one has a wreath, one has some money, diamonds, and jewels, and one has a hand holding something with a tail, so, or a string. So we don't know. These are all ideas, right? These are all possibilities. So you're learning about the possibilities of something. You might be exploring your options here. I'm also hearing symptoms. Might wanna, I don't know, maybe you're looking on online to see like, what is this, what is that? That just popped into my head. So the gift you will receive, and I want to say, uh-oh, is the Magician in reverse here. Gemini, Scorpio, Sagittarius energy here, also sometimes Virgo. Either way, this is the gift you will receive. Okay, I am getting Scorpio from this. usually when I get this card, there's a couple things that can come up here. Number one, this is a trickster energy. This is someone saying they're going to do something, but they have no intention behind that, what they're saying. So they can't, they might talk a big talk, but they're not going to walk the walk. This is like a sleazy car salesman, snake oil salesman. Okay, so you can't really trust this person. They might have big fancy words, but you're going to want to check the fine print here. You want to go do your background checks. You want to verify that they say they have whatever they have in their coffers. Do your due diligence. Someone here might be blowing smoke up your ass, Capricorn. And maybe you are having a hard time sleeping because you sense that someone here is lying to you. All right. So either way, this is the gift you will receive. This could be a difficult lesson here in this position because you might be putting too much emphasis on these opportunities that aren't real yet. And you need to make a decision here, possibly. I'm not sure. We'll have to see. Let's go ahead and clarify. Let's go ahead and get some guidance. Capricorn, December 6th through the 12th, Spirit, can you give Capricorn some guidance for the next week? What is your guidance for Capricorn? We have confidence is your key to success, new moon in Leo. So whatever you do this week, it's important that you bring that confidence, okay? If you're selling something, if you're having a business conversation, whatever it is you're doing, it's really important that you bring that confidence. Confidence is everything here. Maybe you're starting a new project or introducing an idea. Make sure you're coming out as confident here, okay? Because people can sense weakness. People can sense you're not so sure about something. So if you're presenting an idea, do it with confidence. Now, we also have Leo energy here. So you might be speaking to someone who is very confident this week. You might very well be speaking to a Leo. And the reason why the Leo is successful is because they are very confident and they probably exude that. That's something you like, probably. That's probably a quality you like about them. All right, let's see. What other advice do you have for Capricorn, December 6th through the 12th? Have faith in your dreams, waxing crescent moon. Well, I'll be darned. What do we have? The Seven of Cups here. This is a card of daydreaming and fantasy here. So it seems like you're worried that maybe this is just, sandcastles in the sky, pie in the sky, right? But they're asking you to be confident and have faith in your dreams. So this is kind of spinning this in a new direction. It's not as bad as I thought, actually, here. So let's see. I don't know. The skeptic in me is like, well, why is this card coming up as the gift Capricorn will receive? So if the intention is there, the words are there, the intention is there, you should have everything you need to manifest. So I guess my question is, why aren't you manifesting here? Someone might be preventing you from doing something as well. Someone might be saying some things that they don't have any right to say to you. The energy is gaining momentum, waxing moon. Okay. So whatever it is you're dreaming up, scheming up, planning here, discussing with someone else, they really want you to have faith and confidence in those things. If you are coming from a place of fear, you're not going to be able to manifest those things at all. So it's very important that we start having faith, and maybe there is some shadow work you're going to be doing this week, but you shouldn't let that hold you back. Because it looks like you have all the potential to manifest something here into reality. It's just a matter of believing in those dreams. So Capricorn, this is what I have for you over the next week. Thank you so much for tuning in. This is your weekly forecast. Take care, all of you. I'll see you next week. Bye.